I want to report now that Dow's down 1,000, it's not negative 1,000, but it's down 1,000 from its highs last night as futures. This is now, I think it's in negative territory. It was up 1,200 points last night on futures because of President Trump saying, we're going to take decisive action, Jason Miller, Jack Maxey. And I think now as the reality setting in, that there's a way between the cup and the lip, right, as far as the plan being thought through and the agreement by Democrats, you're starting to get in that tussle, and markets are starting to show you what they think about uncertainty in this regard. So markets are, in massive selling in Europe. And I think the Europe situation, Jack Maxey, is what you bring up. You have an entire country. And Italy, look, Germany, Italy, France, England, that's the cornerstone of Europe. Scandinavia, you got these European countries, you got Spain, they're all great. Don't get me wrong, but you've got Italy, Germany, and France, the core of the industrial power of Europe. You now have an entire nation that is in quarantine and in lockdown. And it's one of the most robust, vibrant industrial bases, particularly in the north. Now you got massive selling in Europe because you're seeing a lack of leadership. You're not closing the borders. Guys are not taking decisive action. You got a lot of guys coming on and whining that we're going to have a problem. The Italians, and by the way, it's been very imperfect how they've done this. They leaked the document the other night. People got the hell out of the northern Italy. The reason they went to lockdown the whole country is so many guys fled the north, not knowing what this is going to be. We've got viewers. You know, it's hashtag war room. Pandemic. Also go to the live stream. We want all your comments. We got people from all over the world blowing our phones up, blowing our systems up there. And the guys from Italy are telling us, hey, this thing is bad because of what Joe Norman's saying. The gating event is the ICU units, right? When people get sick, they have to have it. There's been some debate about this exponential growth. I've seen a couple of guys on TV and a couple of guys on the news site saying, you know, the Joe Normans of the world and a lot of these scientists, the Dr. Lawrence, the Imperial College, when they talk about these growth rates, that they really can't back up the exponential growth. So when you say exponential growth, from what set of mathematics can you specifically point to show exponential growth?
So, I mean, it's essentially what's called a branching process. So if there, you know, you hear about the reproduction value, the R-naught, that's on average how many people does a single infected person infect. If that's anywhere above one, then you have something that compounds in time. And so that compounding can, let's say you had a doubling, right? So the RO is two.